Attention, students of ICSE class 9 and 10 and intermediate first year. Do subscribe to Study with Sudhir YouTube channel where we cover English literature, history, civics, geography, biology and English grammar and many important motivational videos too. Don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you can get regular updates.
हेलो एंड वेलकम टू स्टडी विद सुधीर योर डिजिटल क्लासरूम डिजिटल कक्षा स्टडी विद सुधीर में आपका स्वागत है. आई एम टी एस सुधीर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट समथिंग वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट्स एक्चुअली गोइंग टू डिसाइड योर फेट एज फार एज दी क्लास 10 आईसीएसई बोर्ड एग्जाम्स आर कंसर्न बिकॉज दैट विल ऑन दैट विल डिपेंड हाउ मेनी मार्क्स यू स्कोर एंड द टॉपिक इज हाउ टू इम्प्रेस योर एग्जामिनर. डू वी नो द एग्जामिनर? नो. देन हाउ डू वी इम्प्रेस हिम? Listen to this video right till the end because this is going to give you important tips on how exactly to present your paper in order to impress the examiner who you don't know at all, right? Sounds like an interesting blind date of sorts, right? So, in the month of April, 10 new persons are going to enter your life. This is not an astrological prediction, right? This is how astrological predictions are normally made. But this is a fact, right? Because the strange part though, it would be that you wouldn't know who these 10 people are, but these 10 people are going to impact your life, okay? Are going to have a bearing on this part of your life at this point in time. So, let's present the examiner. Now, as you get set to write your answers in the board examination, you need to know what would be the mindset of the examiner. And as you write, and especially questions like, when you are writing the essay, the composition in the English language paper or the nibandh in the Hindi paper or the programming in the computer's paper, you need to know, will my examiner actually like this? Uske bare mein aap zarur sochiye ki kya unko ye nibandh pasand aayega ya nahi. How would he react to this kind of an argumentative essay? I am not saying let it have a bearing on you, but if you are writing an original short story, think about it yourself that will this interest a third person? Always have that thought in your mind. Now, who is the examiner? He's obviously a teacher, like the teachers that you have in your school. Many of your teachers also must be going in for checking the papers. So, you would have a basic idea about what an examiner looks like in that sense, right? The usual norm I'm given to understand is that papers, the answer papers from one city are sent to another city or region. For instance, papers from Chennai are sent to Mumbai, papers from Punjab are sent to Hyderabad, and so on and so forth. Of course, the board will obviously shuffle this process. It's not like always Chennai papers are sent to Mumbai or always Punjab papers are sent to Hyderabad. Aisa nahi hoga. They would shuffle this process every year, but this is normally usually the norm. So, if you are living in say Kolkata, your papers are unlikely to be checked by teachers in Kolkata. They may be checked by teachers perhaps in Ahmedabad or in Mumbai or in Delhi, right? Now, when the examiner actually gets your answer paper, there is an invisible link that is immediately established between you and the examiner. Even though he doesn't know you, she doesn't know you, and you obviously don't know the examiner. The visible part, there is an invisible link and there is a visible link. The visible link is your answer sheet. The visible link is your answer sheet. The invisible link, of course, is how the examiner, depending on what you have written in the answer sheet, imagines what the student would be like. You know, he or she may not be able to guess whether, you know, whether you are a male student or a female student, but they generally get an idea about what kind of a student has written this kind of an answer, right? And how you perform in this visible and invisible link, on that depends how well you score marks in that particular subject in the examination. Number one, of course, largely depends. A lot many people talk about are teachers ko to paise milte hain, isliye they are in a hurry to check the answer sheets. Let's not deride teachers like that. They are professionals. They are professionals. They are expected to do a professional job, and I would believe largely, at least as far as the ICSE board is concerned, they do a fairly professional job. Okay, of course they will be paid for it. I mean, they are spending their time on it. Not everyone does things for free. They obviously get paid for it, and what's wrong with that? I mean, they are subject experts, right? So The first thing is that your luck factor. Agar aapka paper morning mein mila, when the examiner is feeling fresh in the mind, you know, it's quite possible that he or she may react positively to your examination paper, answer paper. If he or she gets your answer paper just before lunch when he or she is feeling hungry, kuch bhi ho sakta hai, hai na? So that is as far as your luck factor is concerned. It may play a small role, a 1%, 2% role is what I would largely think, because I still believe teachers would be largely professional in the manner in which they go about doing their job, and the ICSE board insists on a more student-friendly approach. This is something which many examiners have told me. The quality of the paper just before you. If by chance you have done a very good paper and the student before you, whose paper has been checked by that examiner, has done a very bad paper, you obviously will look far better in comparison, and that will actually go in your favor. But supposing the student before you has done very well and you have done so-so, that is another bit of the luck factor, the quality of the paper before you, and especially in essays, composition like English and Hindi, these kind of things may actually play a role. Then, now let's look at what kind of things you should do in order to impress the examiner, which is very, very important. The first thing that you need to take care of is the neatness quotient. Now, what is the neatness? Okay. The neatness quotient I am referring to is the handwriting and how the entire answer sheet looks. Does it look all scribbled over the place? Does it look very, very difficult handwriting to decipher? Ki he is not able to make out ye T likha hai ya L likha hai, ye P likha hai ya H likha hai. You know, those kind of things which may actually impact how many marks he or she gives you. So a neat, tidy paper will always leave a good impression on the examiner. So please ensure that your paper looks smart, neat, crisp and tidy. Okay, the first impression is always, it's necessary that the first impression is always very, very positive. Number two, crisp answers, no beating about the bush, idhar udhar ki baatein nahi likhi, come to the straight to the point and finish it off. Okay, good language skills. Essay mein ek cheez ka aap zarur dhyan rakhi, I had kind of referred to it even in the two video lessons that we had done specifically on essays in English. Your first 3 to 4 to 5 lines are very, very important. If in the first 3 to 4 to 5 lines you are beating about the bush, lamba choda intro likh diya jiska koi connection hi nahi hai topic ke saath. See, the thing is that they are also going to be going through a lot of answer sheets in that limited amount of time. There will also be a fatigue factor. So you need to factor that. So you need to come to the point straight, write in language which will impress the examiner, you know. So if the first 3, 4, 5 lines are not great, then he or she may not even bother to read through very carefully. He will read because he's a professional. He will read, but his heart will not be in it. Or he will go through it without actually applying his mind through it. And who will be the loser? The loser will be you. So ensure that your first 3, 4 lines of pehla impression hai, it should be love at first sight as far as the examiner is concerned vis-a-vis you. So, pehle isme impress karo har answer mein. That should be your effort. Come to the point taki seedha answer. Okay, ye keywords likh diye hain normal answers mein. Marks de do, 3 marks straight away. Subheadings, boxed, underlined. It's a great tactic to look smart. We have spoken about it at length. Diagrams need to be neat. Some students have been writing to me saying that our diagrams are not good. I don't have a great way of drawing diagrams. Practice karo. You don't have a choice. No spelling mistakes. Spelling mistakes can really kind of put off the examiner. No big paragraphs. Break it down into points, small paragraphs. Point, 2-3 line ka paragraph, line chodo, next point, subheading, underline, examiner khush hua. Then, if you have a small handwriting and you crowd every line with about 12 to 13 to 14 words, don't do that. Work on your handwriting to ensure that each line has just about 7 to 8 sentences, because that is the general way they calculate, okay, is essay mein itne sare words likhe hain, okay. And 12 to 13 words in a sentence will also make it difficult for the examiner to read it. So clearly 7 to 8 words in a sentence would be the optimum number of words in a particular line. To utne pe hi aap rakhiyega, okay. Presentation, How you present, especially in subjects like geography, physics, history, civics, give reasons to what happened, like the causes of the Second World War, causes of the First World War. How you will inform the examiner, work on how you will presentation, because content aapko malum hoga. It's quite likely that given the kind of hard work that you have done, given the amount of revision you have done, you will know the content. But how you present the content is actually going to determine how many marks you will get. Correct? Understood? Point? So you need to work on your presentation in the next 3-4 days. Work on how you will actually present the reasons. You know, okay, these are the reasons. This is how I will write it. Prepare everything in the mind. Us samay pe jaake, don't get confused and jumble up everything. Okay. So that is something which is very, very important, because if you mess up the explaining part, you will lose out on those precious marks. Because even if you know the content, you may have messed up on the presentation. Because aajkal ke zamane mein, content is king, but marketing is an emperor, right? You need to market also pretty well. So what you have to do in your answer exam is to market the amount of knowledge that you have. So the quality of your marketing will have a bearing on the amount of marks that you get in the examination. Okay. Now you are allowed to attempt the questions in any order. A lot of students keep asking me this. You are allowed to attempt the questions in any order. You can start with question number 3, you can go to 5, then 1, 2, 3. Yes, of course, if you start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you make it easy for the examiner, no doubt. But he is not going to take an umbrage over the fact that ki aapne pehla chautha question attempt kiya, fir pehle pe aaye, fir panchwe pe gaye. No. He also understands that he want to attempt the questions jinke ki uttar aapko theek se malum hai, whose answers you know pretty well. So that's perfectly alright. What you should not do, what you should not do, and please remember this, that if within question number 4 there is A, B, C, D, E, okay, you should ideally go from A to B to C to D to E. Don't go to D, then B, then E. Don't do that, because he may get confused. He may still check your answers, no doubt, and he will mark you. But it's quite possible that in this jumbling up, he may actually miss up, make a mistake with the amount of marks, especially if the 5 questions carry different kind of marks. Ek 2 mark ka question ho sakta hai, ek 3 mark ka. So sometimes instead of 3 marks, he may allot you 2 and thinking that ye 2 mark ka question hai. So don't do that. In your own interest, go in order as far as the sub questions are concerned. Also, supposing in answer 4AB, you know AB, you know DE, but you don't know C, and you think main isko baad mein likhunga, and somewhere at the end you have written 4C. Don't do that. He will think that you have not answered 4C, because these 5 questions, he will try to mark them together. If it's a careful examiner, a considerate examiner, he may mark you, but the possibility of it going wrong is also there. So please do not take such risks. If you don't know the answer, leave some space for 4C and come back to it again, but don't put it out somewhere separately in a different, on a different page. So that is something which you need to do. As I mentioned, ICSE does ask its examiners to be student friendly, but you also need to be examiner friendly. And what I mean by examiner friendly, write the keywords, underline them, the content matters, as I said, your style and presentation matters, write your question number in bold letters, unique ID, roll number, wo sab to aap likhi denge. The other mistake many students make is to start the examination paper with very neat handwriting. First 3-4 pages, good handwriting. Uske baad jaldbazi hone lag jati hai. They don't know the answers or they are in a hurry. And then the handwriting progressively deteriorates. That kind of gives an indication to the examiner that this student has begun to feel nervous, and the quality of these answers is not as good as the quality of the answers on the first 3-4 pages. So ensure that you have a basic uniform kind of a handwriting through the entire answer sheet, because he will be able to read your state of mind through that visible link that I spoke about, the visible link of the answer sheet between you and the examiner. So be consistent is my suggestion to you. Okay. So this is something which you need to do in order to impress the examiner. Okay. So that he gives you good marks and you leave a good impression on him. So I hope these tips are useful. I hope you will put them to practice. I hope you have made a note of them, and all the best to you. Thank you very much for watching.